Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel Trouble Free. In this video, I am going to share my own personal experience about Accenture TFA, like how I prepared, how I cleared, like after completion of modules, after how many days I got my exam date and how my exam went on, how after how many days I got my results. So I'm going to share everything. It's been a while, almost it's been more than 1 month since I have written my TFA. I've been planning to make this video from 1 month actually, but I was not able to make it, but today finally I'm going to do this. I'm going to share my own TFA experience with you. So let's get into the video. Actually, I've completed my modules somewhere around 13th of August, and I got a mail about my TFA exam. You'll be getting on your personal mail itself. I got a mail about that somewhere around on 16th of August maybe, or 17th of August. I don't exactly remember. On 16th or 17th of August, I had an orientation. First, you'll be getting a mail related to orientation of TFA, which will be around for 30 minutes. They'll tell you what TFA is, you'll be proctored, you'll have to show, so everything they'll be explaining about what is that. And once you are done with the orientation, the next day or in the next day, you'll be having your exams. Okay, this is about the students of Java modules. I'll also make even cloud modules also, the same scenario will happen, but there is a bit difference between Java module students and cloud module students, that is infrastructure students. I'll tell you about that also in a separate video if you want me to. And so you'll be getting a mail. First, you'll have your mock test. I got a mail on 17th or 16th, I don't remember, as I said. My orientation was on 17th of August and my mock test was on 18th of August, and my actual TFA was on 20th. Okay, within 1 week of completion of my modules, my TFA was completed. Okay, so I got mail just before the day of my mock test, or one day before that, that's all. Okay, so you will be having the TFA, you'll be getting your schedule for your MCQs, your hands-on as well. You'll be having different slots, MCQs and hands-on, everything will not be continuous. You'll be having at least half an hour or 1 hour break in between MCQs and hands-on. Okay, done. So that's all. Yeah, and actually you'll be writing MCQs on different platform, not on the platform where you have learned your modules. MCQ will be on Mettle platform. If you have written the Accenture main exam, right, like cognitive and coding round, so in that platform itself you will be having your MCQs as well. But when coming to hands-on is not on Mettle platform, it is on the tech stack itself, that is where in the platform where we have learned our modules, in the same platform you'll be having your hands-on as well. And once you'll be getting your mail, right, so once you get your mail, you have to check all your details, and you'll be when you click on that, you'll have to download all the, everything will be described in the mail, you don't worry about that. Next, on the exam, what you have to do is sit at least 10 minutes before the computer. Okay, lock your room. You know how you have to write your proctored exams, right? But this is human proctor, you have to be more careful. So first they'll be asking you to show your ID is nothing but you need to show your PAN card. Okay, the other IDs are not allowed actually. They'll specifically ask you to show your PAN card. You should show your PAN card. That is, you need to take a picture of this PAN card with the front camera of your laptop or the webcam, whatever it is, whichever you're using. Make sure that the picture is very clear. If it is not clear, they'll definitely ask you to take it again. So all your time will be wasted there. So make sure that you will be taking the picture properly. You will have to give your picture as well. Okay, when you're giving your picture, be careful. Even your face should be clearly visible and all. Don't waste your time there. That is what I want to tell you. The first time during the mock test, I wasted a lot of time with the PAN card, because the picture, the proctor says the picture is always blur, right? So make sure that the picture is very clear. Okay, done. And about the TFA pattern, I've already made a video about TFA pattern. You can watch that video. I have made a separate video for cloud modules. I have made a separate video for Java as well. You can watch that video. There you'll be getting an idea of how TFA pattern goes on, right? And if I have to speak about the level of difficulty of questions which I have written, and yeah, first let me tell you, I got 84% in my TFA and I got results within 1 week of my TFA. Within 1 week, you'll be getting your results to your personal mail ID, not your Accenture mail ID. You'll be getting it to your personal mail ID. You'll be getting the result, okay? When coming to cloud modules, you'll be just getting whether you're qualified or not, whether you have cleared or not. But whereas in the Java modules, you'll be getting the percentage as well. So I got 84% in my first attempt itself. So the level of difficulty, if you ask me, they are not very difficult and they are not very easy as well. They are of moderate difficulty. And if you genuinely complete all the modules, if you have genuinely completed all the modules, all the hands-on questions and all, if you have really done all of them, then TFA will be definitely easy for you. Okay, so you need not worry too much about TFA. Even if you are from a non-CS or non-IT background also, utilize the 45 days which are being given to you for the practicing. Utilize those 45 days completely, because of even after TFA also, when you join the company, when you go to your stream specific training, they will obviously, they will be obviously in a perception that these people have already learned pre-learning modules. They are already aware of those concepts. So let us continue from this. So even if you don't learn now also, later it will become a big difficulty for you. So I want you to learn. I want to be genuine towards TFA. Okay, that's all. And yeah, time. Yeah, time. You'll be getting enough time. You need not worry about time, whether 70 minutes or 60 minutes or whatever it is, 80 minutes, will that be enough? You need not worry about time. Time will be definitely sufficient for you. And since you don't have any negative marking in case of MCQs, it's better that you will be solving all the questions, even if you don't know any questions also in the last, just guess them. And when moving over to the hands-on, as you are already aware of Tech Stack platform, where you have practiced so many questions related to Java and SQL, you can obviously handle the hands-on as well. You have to check for the test cases. So depending on the number of test cases passed, your percentage will be calculated, right? So I hope everybody is clear with this video. And this is all about my Accenture TFA experience. And I'm very happy that I could score 84% in my first attempt. And all the best to all of you who are having it in the near future. And thanks for watching my video till the end. And if you want any other videos like this, just let me know in the comment section. I've been a little busy these days, but I promise you that I'll be back with again all the updates and all, to keep you updated. And also thanks for watching the video till the end. And so many people are asking about the doubts related to documents upload as well, right? So about that also, I'm planning to make a separate video. So thanks for watching the video. Let's meet up in the next coming video with another topic.